What's the most amazing thing you've ever experienced? That was the question Emirates had to answer for its new advertising campaign. It's called Keep Discovering, and it challenges people to do something they've never done before. It asks people to keep rejecting the ordinary and always try and do the extraordinary.
Our aim in shooting these TV commercials really is to lift the brand image of the airline above what we see is a fairly monotonous series of TV commercials for airlines nowadays. And specifically the strategy is to reposition the airline as a global brand.
The majority of people who fly Emirates once always fly it again, which we thought was pretty amazing. But I think
They become loyal customers after they fly once.
It's
like, they fly it again and again.
It's like 90% or something. It's an amazing amount. And so our job was basically to try and get people to just try it once. Just try it once, because we knew if they try it once, you know, they'll try it again, which is fantastic. So we decided to create a campaign around first-time experiences, trying something for the first time.
Emirates travel the globe, capturing all sorts of people having all sorts of incredible experiences, from diving with sharks in South Africa to seeing snow for the first time, from cold and snowy Zurich streets to the heat of the desert summer in Dubai. This is the story of how they made it happen.
Info.
The first scene in the film was to feature the reactions of two African businessmen to their first sight of snow. The scene was to be set in Zurich, but with the ad being filmed in the middle of July, the streets of the Swiss capital were unhelpfully snow-free. So the challenge was to recreate Zurich 3,000 miles away in Cape Town, South Africa. A special effects crew was flown in from the UK, and using a fake form made from paper, they filled an entire Cape Town street with the snow substitute overnight. To add to the realism of the scene, our two actors really had never seen snow before. The effect was stunning. From Cape Town, the next stop was 2 hours away, up the east coast of South Africa at Hans Baai, the notorious Shark Alley, famous for its hungry population of great whites who come to feed on the seal pubs nearby.
So it was only 6 months ago we were filming in South Africa. And we were sat around and Rob was discussing, wouldn't it be the most exciting thing in the world to go and film sharks? And 6 months later, look what we're doing.
This next scene was to feature two girls experiencing their first ever shark dive.
So it's your first time in the water today?
Yeah.
For anybody who ever wants to dive, shark cage diving is one of the most exciting diving experiences you can ever have.
It would involve filming at sea, with underwater cameras and with highly dangerous animals, which, unfortunately, don't take direction, if they turn up at all. The cast and crew waited nervously for the star to make an appearance. And then, on the morning of the second day, success. A 10-foot great white came looking for breakfast. The crew rushed to get the cage in the water before the shark disappeared. But after half an hour, our star had had enough. So it was back to the pool to get the rest of the shots required. After 3 days, the scene was in the can.
That's really scary.
Would you go down again?
I don't know. I think I would.
From Hans Bay, it was back to Cape Town for the next sequence. Two Swedish businessmen experiencing the madness of a high-tech Tokyo gaming lounge. The lounge was to be recreated in an old theatre and feature everything from miniature horse racing tracks to virtual golf booths to mannequins dressed as Japanese schoolgirls. To make the scene authentic, the crew from a Japanese ship were recruited as extras. The scene would involve the use of green screen, a production technique where actors work on blank backgrounds with effects dropped in post-production. When it all came together, you'd never have known you weren't in downtown Tokyo. From the cold of Cape Town, the next stop was the desert heat of Dubai, home of Emirates, and the location for the final two scenes in the ad. First off was Dubai International Airport to get the final end-frame sequence. A little boy excitedly running through the airport to see the Emirates plane he's about to fly on for the very first time. The final scene was perhaps the most spectacular yet. It would feature a son treating his mother to her first ever helicopter ride, starting with a takeoff from the top of the spectacular Burj Al Arab Hotel, 1,000 feet above the deep blue sea around Dubai. The scene required meticulous planning, with the sea winds around the top of the hotel making landing a helicopter extremely tricky, and no small amount of discomfort for the cast and crew, with temperatures reaching 45 degrees on the helipad high atop the hotel. But with results like these, the effort felt more than worth it.
We don't fool around, guys. You know, we have really good communication.
With the TV campaign completed, it was on to the press shoot. The campaign was to be shot by world-renowned photographer Doug Menwes.
Thank you.
10 ads in 10 days, in locations as varied as Wormwood Scrubs, the Cafe Royal in London's Regent Street, the Coronet Cinema, as featured in the film Notting Hill, and a remote beach in Sardinia.
So I can just play like this.
Australians, Africans, Americans and Europeans and Brits alike. So it's a wonderful mix of people that complements Emirates quite well. And what we liked about working with the agency and what we're enjoying literally on set as we speak is the spirit that is within the agency and within Emirates to get things done.
Thousands of miles, 3 different continents, hundreds of people. Making the Emirates Keep Discovering campaign was a truly epic journey. To appear in cinemas, on TVs, in newspapers, magazines, and on billboards around the globe from autumn 2002. So Emirates can help the world to keep discovering.